Yesterday, I heard that to-to-to-to-to-to-to. And then I said, wait a minute. I remember in my youth, I used to hear that a whole lot. And who did I come upon? Mr. John Bowzer, Bauman, the guy I listened to doing that all along.
Well, you were too good. Now I can't do it. You're too good.
You know you can do it. How you
doing? That was too operatic. That was very good. I was very impressed.
Let me tell you something. When I heard it, the ears went like that. I said, I remember that. How are you doing today, sir?
I'm doing great.
You are at a progressive conference in Philadelphia. What are you doing here?
I've been to pretty much every one of these for the last, five or six years? Seven, yeah, something like that.
And who are you representing?
These are very important. Well, I am a volunteer. I do everything that I do for free in this area, but I am president of what's called Social Security Works PAC.
Right.
And we work on senior issues, so we work on Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, fighting to lower drug prices. Mm-hmm. And, I'm pleased to say that during the last cycle, election cycle, we work on, my purview is elections.
Right.
And during the last election cycle, I actually physically went to 57 different campaigns.
Wow.
And did events with 57 different candidates.
Right.
So probably about, with multiple events for candidates, probably did about 100 events altogether or something like that. And every one of them was about bum 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 dang a dang dang ding a dong ding. I love Social Security.
Yes, hey, look, how else am I gonna start the morning, man?
Low notes are good in the morning.
Low notes are good in the morning because you're still there. Now, how have you been finding the space these days at promoting Social Security, promoting these things? Because in these times, how we've gotten with, we don't want these programs, or we want to cut these programs. How successful?
Well, blissfully, very successful.
Right.
And in this last cycle, seniors, there are two things about older voters. Mm-hmm. Number one is that they always show up.
Right.
Number two is that they don't always vote in their own best interest.
Interest. Right.
Right. And we're used to that. We have been losing older voters for several cycles now. One of the biggest things that happened in this last cycle was that we pretty much broke even. We were
at
49% of older voters, and because they always show up, it makes an enormous difference.
Right.
So one of the biggest reasons why we were able to flip, 40 or 41 seats, depending on what happens in North Carolina,
right,
in that special election was, or the real, the redo of the of North Carolina 9. Right, pretty much one of the biggest reasons that we were able to accomplish all this was because we changed the dynamics with older voters who showed up like they always do in droves.
And you know what? Earlier you said they normally vote against your interests.
Often.
The interesting thing about it is they don't know it. And having people like you going out there, because, I don't want to make light of this. I mean, a lot of folks first know you because they see you on TV.
This is why, I'm fairly valuable in this fight.
Right.
Is because I can get some attention. I can get some earned media for the candidates.
Right.
We can focus on the issues.
Right.
And when you get older voters to focus on the issues that really do affect them, they normally do come over to our side.
And do the right thing.
And do the right thing.
Right.
For themselves.
Right.
And for the country as a whole.
Absolutely.
Because, the simple facts are, before Social Security was passed in 1935, 50%, a little bit over 50% of American seniors had incomes below the poverty line.
Right.
And before Medicare was passed in 1965, still a little bit over 35% of American seniors had incomes below the poverty line. So these Social Security and Medicare are literally the two most successful domestic programs in the entire history of the United States of America. And they have brought the poverty rate among seniors down to 8.7% from 50%.
Imagine that.
So that's a tremendous difference. And once you get people to focus on that, they really understand how important these programs are.
And understand the reality behind it.
Right. And, relative to the question you initially asked, it really is important to note that we have moved the goalposts from discussions of no cuts, which were even a couple of cycles ago. The goalposts have now moved to expansion.
That is so important.
Right. It's the critical thing. And our questionnaire, which was pretty simple,
right.
was only five questions
right.
for a candidate, was will you vote to expand Social Security, vote to expand Medicare, vote to expand Medicaid as defined in the Affordable Care Act,
right.
fight to lower drug prices, and will you always use the term earned benefits to describe Social Security and Medicare
right.
and never refer to those programs as entitlements.
Yeah.
And that was the entire questionnaire.
Wow.
So all 75 of our endorsees, which included you know people running as Democrats who
right.
were definitely centrist or even sort of conservative
right.
Democrats,
right.
agreed to all five of those questions. So what that really means is that even members of the Blue Dog Caucus
yes.
of the Democratic Party
right.
have pledged to fight for Social Security expansion.
Right. right.
And that's a big change from the way things have been in the past.
I think that is so important. Well, please, in closing, give a message directly in that camera to our listeners.
Well, the message is always, for me, going to be the same, which is, good night and Greece for peace. And don't forget about Social Security and Medicare.
And go vote, my
and
brother.
Of course, go vote.
Thank you so kindly.
My
and you
pleasure.
Have a wonderful day and enjoy the rest of the conference.
You too.
All right.